says, be ye followers of me, even as I also am of Christ. Now I praise you, brethren, that you remember me in all things and keep the ordinances as I delivered them to you. That I would have you know that the head of every man is Christ, and the head of every woman is the man, and the head of Christ is God. Every man praying or prophesying, having his head covered, dishonoreth his head. But every woman that prayeth or prophesieth with her head uncovered, dishonoreth her head. For that is even all one as if she were shaven. For the woman be not coveted, let her also be shorn. But if it be a shame for a woman to be shorn or shaven, let her be covered. For a man indeed ought not to cover his head, forasmuch as he is the image and glory of God, but the woman is the glory of the man. For the man is not of the woman, but the woman of the man. Neither was the man created for the woman, but the woman for the man. For this case ought the woman to have power on her head because of the angel. Nevertheless, neither is the man without the woman, neither the woman without the man in the Lord. For as the woman is of the man, even so is the man also by the woman. But all things of God. Judge in yourself, is it comely that a woman pray unto God in covenant? Doth not even nature itself teach you that if a man have long hair, it is a shame unto him? But if a woman have long hair, it is a glory to her, for her hair is given her for a covenant. But if any man seem to be contentious, we have no such custom, neither the churches of God. Now in this that I declare unto you, I praise you not that you come together not for the better, but for the worse. For first of all, when you come together in the church, I hear that there be divisions among you, and I partly believe it. For there must be also heresies among you, that they which are approved may be made manifest among you. When you come together, therefore, into one place, this is not to eat the Lord's Supper. For in eating, everyone taketh before after his own supper, and one is hungry, another is drunk. What? Have you not houses to eat and drink in? Or despise ye the church of God and shame them that have none? What shall I say to you? Shall I praise you in this? I praise you not. For I have received of the Lord, which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he brake it and said, take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me. And after the same manner also he took his cup when he hath supped, saying, this cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as oft as ye drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, ye shall show the Lord's death till he comes. Wherever, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink this cup of the Lord unworthily shall be guilty of the body and blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself, so let him eat of that bread and drink of that cup. For he that eateth and drinketh unworthily eateth and drinketh damnation to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. For this cause many are weak and sickly among you, and many sleep. For if we would judge ourselves, we should not be judged. But when we are judged, we are chastened of the Lord, that we should not be condemned with him the word. Wherefore, my brethren, when ye come together to eat, tarry from one another. And if any man hunger, let him eat at home, and that ye not come together into condemnation. And the rest will I set in order when I come. Father, this morning as we come to you, we partake of this communion. Lord, we pray that each and every one that's here, Lord, has a clean heart and clean life, Lord. Father, if anyone here, Lord, has sin in their life, this morning, God, I pray, Lord, they'll come to the altar before we can faith in this, Lord, and get things right with you. Father, by doing this communion service this morning, Lord, we do it in honor of thee. In Jesus' name. Amen. When we come here together, we're going to take it back and take it part of the community. We're going to take it back first to the other body. We're going to take it to the other body. Amen. We come through again, we're going to take off this Sunday. We're going to take this place to the rest of our body. We're going to do the same up there. Amen. When he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of me." After the same manner, also he took the cup which he had sucked, saying, "This cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as often as you drink it in remembrance of me."
Sheriff Shelby Dunn, Phil. And it don't matter if it's little sand or big.
Just suppose God searched through heaven, couldn't find one willing to be the supreme sacrifice that was needed. That could buy eternal life for you and me. Had it not been for a place called Mount Calvary, had it not been for the old rugged cross, for this man called Jesus, then forever my soul would be lost. I'm so glad he was willing to drink his bitter cup. Although he prayed, Father, let it pass from me. And I'm so glad he never called not one of heaven's angels. From my hand, pull the nails that torment me. Had it not been for a place called Mount Calvary, had it not been for the old rugged cross, and had it not been for this man called Jesus, then forever my soul would be lost. Then forever my soul would be John chapter 20. We're going to continue on from the scripture we read this morning.
John chapter 20.
Let's all stand for reading the God's word. Starting with verse 1. The first day of the week cometh, Mary Magdalene early, when it was yet dark, and to the sepulchre, and seeth a stone taken away from the sepulchre. Then she runneth and cometh to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved, and saith unto them, they have taken away the Lord out of the sepulchre, and we know not where they have laid him. Peter therefore went, and that other disciple, and came to the sepulchre. So they ran both together, and the other disciple did outrun Peter and came first to his sepulcher. And he, stooping down and looking in, saw the linen clothes lying, yet went he not in. Then cometh Simon Peter following him, and went into the sepulcher, and seeing the linen clothes lying, and the napkin that was about his head, not lying with the linen clothes, but wrapped together in a place by itself. Then went in also that other disciple which came first into the sepulcher, and he saw and believed. For yet they knew not the scripture, that he must rise again from the dead. Then the disciples went away again unto their own home. But Mary stood without at the sepulchre weeping, and as she wept, she stooped down and looked into the sepulchre, and seeth two angels in white sitting, the one at the head and the other at the feet, where the body of Jesus had lain. And they say unto her, Woman, why weepest thou? She saith unto them, Because they have taken away my Lord, and I know not where they have laid him. And then she had thus said, she turned herself back and saw Jesus standing, and knew not that it was Jesus. Jesus saith unto her, Woman, why weepest thou? Whom seekest thou? She, supposing him to be the gardener, saith unto him, Sir, if thou hast borne him hence, tell me where thou hast laid him, and I will take him away. Jesus saith unto her, Mary. She turned herself and saith unto him, Rabboni, which is to say, Master. Jesus saith unto her, Touch me not, for I am not yet ascended unto my Father, but go to my brethren and say unto them, I ascend unto my Father, your Father, and to my God, and your God. Mary Magdalene came and told the disciples that she had seen the Lord, and that he had spoken these things unto her. Then at the same day at evening, being the first day of the week, when the doors were shut, where the disciples were assembled, for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in the midst, and saith unto them, Peace be unto you. And when he had so said, he showed unto them his hand and his side. Then were the disciples glad when they saw the Lord. Then Jesus to them again, Peace be unto you, as my Father hath sent me, even so I send you. When he had said this, he breathed on them, and saith unto them, Receive ye the Holy Ghost. And whosoever sins you remit, they are remitted unto them. And whosoever sins you retain, they are retained. But Thomas is one of the 12, called Didymus, which was not with them when Jesus came. The other disciples therefore said unto him, We have seen the Lord. But he said unto them, Except I shall see in his hands the print of the nails, and put my finger into the print of the nails, and thrust my hand into his side, I will not believe. And after 8 days, again his disciples were within, and Thomas with them. Then came Jesus, the doors being shut, and stood in the midst, and said, Peace be unto you. Then saith him to Thomas, Reach hither thy finger, and behold my hand, and reach hither thy hand, and thrust it into my side, and be not fearless, be not faithless, but believe. And Thomas answered and said unto him, My Lord and my God. Jesus said unto him, Thomas, because thou hast seen me, thou hast believed. Blessed are they that have not seen, and yet have believed. many other signs truly did Jesus in the presence of his disciples, which nor are written in this book. But these are written that you might be believe that Jesus Christ, the Son of God, and that believing you might have life through his name. Father, as we come to you this morning, Father, we're thankful, Lord, for Jesus going to the cross. Father, we thank you, God, for the cross, that we can look to the cross, Lord. Father, we thank you that Jesus died for us. Lord, that we are guilt-free and have everlasting life. Father, we praise you, and we honor you, and we thank you, Lord, for dying, that we can feel free. And we thank you for rising. Father, we thank you that you're setting us beside the sea. Father, we pray that this message, Lord, will be to honor you and things you've done, Lord, that we could have everlasting life. Just be careful to praise you and honor you for it all. Just in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you.
It is definitely harder. We have in the scripture this morning, we went to Jesus being beaten. He had to carry his cross. But someone took his place down. He went to Calvary. With Jesus to death. And when we went to the tomb, as they placed him in. And 3 days later, we went to the end. You know, it talks about this head down. They say in the old times, when somebody went to somebody's house and they got through eating, always floated their mouth. Placed it on the table. That meant that they would be turned. That's what signifies this. Is after being floated and made separate and clothed, that was Jesus' sign. That he would be turned. And I believe that with all my heart. I'm looking for it. It could be today, it could be tomorrow, it could be this week, this month, this year. I'm looking for it. I'm surprised it's not already done. You know, we've been studying in Revelation, the Bible study. I believe that five of the seven seals have already been broken. And six. I think there's only one more seal to be broken. Because what the Bible says, if these seals are going to ring, we've already seen. If the Lord allows me to, I'm going to preach on that in 7 weeks. If the Lord allows me to, I want to, but I don't want to do it on my own. If I do it on my own, no meaning. The Lord gives it to me. I believe he's kept a lot of it. Knowing that five of his seals are even broken. I thank God that he was willing. Jesus was willing.
go through all that humiliation. I don't know that a more horrible death. I mean, they put him in a whipping post. Beating. A normal man would have died for a beating, much less have to carry his cross. But he carried that cross. More or less fell to his knees because he couldn't bear it out of the way. You know, there was a man went through here a couple of years ago with a cross. His cross had a wheel on it. And that cross had to be heavy. It was made of wood. At least it had a wheel on it. But Christ, when he carried his cross, he had a wheel on it. He had to drag that cross. That weight plus the end of that cross dragging across the mountain. That was that much worse. And how somebody can hear the story and still reject Jesus is beyond. I'm still walking away. And like I said this morning, the humiliation when they nailed him to that cross, they took swords and ripped up his arms. And gallons more. That right there is humiliation. Could you imagine dying through it? People going into the funeral and taking your clothes off of you and ripping them up. Say, who bids $20 for this piece of cloth that we're going to put? Who bids $50 on this thing? That is the most lack of respect anyone can have to do. So dragging. He said, I thirst when they feed him. I can imagine how thirsty he was. I'd like to dry my mouth from what I do. I thirst all the time. But if somebody should hand me a cup of energy, and I took that cup and drank it, I believe in all my heart, and I'm an easy going guy. I tried with it. I don't want to kill them. They hand me a cup of energy. As bad as I'm in first. I don't like energy. I like it cooked with food. But I don't like energy. I don't think anybody likes energy as far as just taking it up and drinking. You do, one person. But can you imagine being that much thirsty, dying on the cross, and asking for a cup of water and getting in? Such disrespect. His death draws more disrespect not have to do anything.
Road. Doggy road. You went through all that. Pearson. Yeah. After he died, though, too. The road. He's alive. He's alive today. Praise God. Now there's countless graves out here. I told Owen Ray yesterday, I said, you need to go count the graves. He said, oh, we know how many members of that. I never will forget him. That's probably the only people you get to listen to. But really, these people need grace. They're living in peace. I know bodies deteriorated. Now, their spirits in heaven, they went to heaven in a minute, they fight. That body is out there just waiting. Just waiting on Jesus' time. Could you imagine being in this church house? I mean, it's going to happen so fast. The Bible says you want to get them out of the grave first. Rise up. I don't know if we've even comprehended this one, but could you imagine sitting and looking out of these windows and then grave first? What a glorious sight. I'm listening to the wind. I get. I'm scared to death of heights. I don't think heights bother me a bit. Somewhere between here and heaven, our spirits will renew us. I believe this with all my heart. Our spirits will renew us and never go out there. When we get our will found. I'm going to go ask you. No more hearing aids, no more canes, no walkers, no wheelchairs. Build in peace. Can you imagine that? Being with Jesus our Savior. Bowing at his feet. Praising, thanking for all he's done. I guess that's why I hate that God decided to spend eternity. We know he'll take that long prayer, but I just thank him for all of these things. Can't thank him enough. Can't thank him enough. If we spent from now to December the 31st of this year, thank you, we would still get it all out. I'll every breath we take is because of his mercy, his grace. Every foot step we take off. God's grace. I'm about 50 times. Thinking about his grace. My body is so tired and so weak. If I had the energy in me, I'd be learning about him. I'd be learning about him. But I thank God. He done this for every person. He didn't do it just for me. He didn't do it just for Ola, or just for Phil, or just for Rosa, Barbara, for Frankie, for Tammy, for Louie. He done it all. every person that's living, every person that's gone on, he died for each one of us. So that we have everlasting. I can't imagine anyone would want to walk away from you. Agony. The disrespect. It's more than human. I know I can. If I don't know my dying death, man, somebody came in and spit on me, set me vinegar, and put me in the fire. I realized he's already dead when they put the fire. That's just one more time to get to that. There you go. Well, they broke the other thing's bottom. They wouldn't touch Jesus. You know why that is? You know why they couldn't touch Jesus? God didn't know why. But then that all he does, and that's true. Disrespect. God would not go out and say, this man. Well, I just can't find the word this morning to express what's in my heart. God put so much in me that I'm having trouble getting it out. I know y'all don't understand that. Maybe Philip does, he's a Sunday school teacher. Sometimes God will fill you up with so much, there's no way you can bring all of that. Because when you're trying to bring out everything you feel that in you, there's too much in there. It's hard to get it back out. But I don't know why it is. I'm having a lot of trouble this morning. I know what I want to say. And until I can bring it out before I can say it, if I do it without it coming out free, I'm doing it on my own. And I don't want to preach on my own. I don't want to make a mess of anything. I don't want to confuse nobody. I want the Word of God to come out. Yeah. And it is so hard to try to understand what Jesus felt when they did. And they made him carry his own cross. I still say I'm one man getting went through that, didn't they? They didn't beat his brother. Didn't have him to carry that cross. They didn't send him with that cross away. Unless it had the force of the ground holding his back. He did. For each one of us. He did it for me. And I didn't deserve it. I've never murdered nobody. I never run around drinking. But I was still a sinner. Worth it. I thank God that I never had the urge. That's a blessing. Those who've been through it know it's a blessing. I never had the urge for drugs.
saying I was perfect. I'm just blessed with what I say, but I didn't know anything. I mean, I was still a sinner. Well, probably the worst of sinners. Even though I didn't drink or take drugs, I was just as bad as the next one. I've sinned in all of the sin. And God gave it to his wife. And I can stand it coming to you. My Savior. If you're watching out there on the internet, Jesus died for you. Your sin. And all it takes, Father, I'm a sinner, but I believe that he died for my sin. And I want to ask you into my heart, cover my sin. Come into my heart, make peace in my heart. Well, if you remember the day you got saved, when you got up, did you feel like you were there? You had a lot of weight with you out there. Mm-hmm. You was a new man in Christ. Huh? Arthur loved it. When you got saved, you remember that day? And a lot of times that peace is so much that you grab it. Mm-hmm. And remember the day you got saved. By the way, I'm not trying to get off the sermon. Tammy got saved after we were married. She thought she got saved and she was here. They didn't leave Christ. They didn't show her how to pray. And she got up, they told her she was saved. And a kid would believe that. God showed her one night in the Bible. She lived that. Oh, okay, okay. She got up and she got me by the hand. I wasn't about to sit there for a long time. But she's never been baptized. We need to set up about this summer. Go down to the river. That's the safest place I know to go. Because y'all don't live in that church, man. I ain't getting out of the river. Not in the water. Some Sunday, if it's okay with the church, we need to set up a Sunday. We go down on house service, and then after the service, we'll help out. We do it all the way up our kids. That's why we need to have a little bit of letting the kids back. So it takes money to keep that thing going. Keep it clean. Keep it, whatever you call it. I ain't never had one.
I didn't know
they had it. Oh, yeah. Yeah, they got a bad time. They love the people. Yeah, you have to call and make an appointment. You know, that way you're not interfering with another church. You just have to make an appointment. But we can use this just for the building, which is right above the. I'll take it to have our service at home.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we have to be
It's okay at the church. We talked about it. Maybe next time we need to get that final road. She's never been baptized. It's gonna be an honor. Get baptized in life. I mean, many preachers didn't do that. So usually when preachers call preachers, wife didn't say, well, she was saved before I called preachers, but she just never got that. It's gonna be an honor. I hit the best that night. That was wrong. I can't see why anyone would ever want to walk away from me, knowing what he's doing. Next year at Easter, if it's okay at the church, I would like to show that movie Passion of Christ. That's okay at the church. I don't want to make nothing. Anybody disagree with me. But I believe that is the closest that we can get to what we can do. My baby raised the sermon that day. He's doing the movie. God has been so good to me. He has brought me through so many. And I know I mentioned this, and I know y'all probably thought of it. I was in a wheelchair for 4 years. my legs were so weak I couldn't stand on them. I had to swing myself from the bed to the wheelchair. It's a trapeze to the bed. I hung on the bed to get the wheelchair. But one morning I woke up. My legs felt good. I could feel them. I rose up and usually I'd have to take my hand to John and pull my legs out and fall down on the floor. That morning, I rose up, got the tripod, and the trapeze, whatever it's called, and pulled my legs down on the floor. And they didn't follow me. Like normal. And I laid myself there. Didn't follow. I took the bed. Didn't follow. Then started hollering and panic all of a sudden. She ran in and I was walking. She said, I only walked it back. And I did. I walked back, sat down on the side of the bed, took the keys. I got my hands on the floor. Now that's the situation. When it takes 2 people, you and your wife to be the best of the good. And all of a sudden, standing there, taking them to the house. He takes no people. That's it. A miracle to do. Yep. And got married. We were told it was going to be married. Before we got married,
special people being on us, I think. I think, and he took care of them. He's done it for 6 years. And if I live to be 62, if I live to be 72, if I live to be 82, 92, 102, he wants to be taken care of. He always has. He always will. I don't have to doubt my mind. God's not going to take me. I know he's going to take care of me. Now, if they're coming out of a wheelchair, make sure it's all bruised. That's a miracle. I think it is. I mean, I'm no fireball preacher. I may be born, for all I know. But you know, a lot of preachers, they get up here and they hound them to death, and it takes an hour and a half to get the message down. And if you slow them down before you can understand them, they're saying the same thing. I know there's times I drag things out a little bit. Some kids drag things out a lot. But, you know, when God says quit, I'm quitting it. And that's your message today. I hope somebody got something out of it, because I should do it. Just knowing what God, what Jesus went through. That's the greatest message, sir. This is the most special day of the year. I mean, Christmas is special. Easter, the most special day of the year. That is true. You can now look at that. That's right. If he hadn't been born, he wouldn't have been crucified. Remember that.